soul. If you ever want something and you call, then I'll come running to fight, and I'll be at your door when there's nothing worth running for. When your mind's made up, when your mind's made up, there's no point trying to change it. When your mind's made up, when your mind's made up, there's no point trying to stop it.
This project came about when we were looking for something global to do at the middle school. We saw a need to really enhance our global education for the students, for them to get a sense of what's going on around the world. So through PolyVision and speaking with Amy Brandt, we started talking and I proposed a few things, and she said, let me get back and I'll talk to my people. And before you know it, she came back and with excitement, and we moved forward with the project and had decided on the Isle of Eigg project.
The Isle of Eigg is one of the most beautiful islands in the world. Lying 10 miles off the Scottish coast, the island has a fascinating history, superb wildlife, and a temperate maritime climate. On February 1st, 2008, the Isle of Eigg entered a new era with the switching on of their island electrification project, which makes 24-hour power available for the first time to all residents and businesses on the island. Until then, they were entirely dependent upon making their own power, and the clattering of generators was always to be heard. Now the generators are silent, and suddenly they have leapt to the forefront of electrical generation using renewable energy resources. Their project is a world leader in the integration of multiple renewable energy sources into a grid system to supply an isolated and scattered small community.
My expectations going into the project were surrounded around having our students have an exposure to look beyond Carteret, look beyond New Jersey, and actually see what's going on around the world, to get an understanding of another culture, of another way of life. And that was certainly something they could relate to when they looked at students from another country. And also to get an appreciation for the fact that although they're very different, they are also very similar. And that was one of the things that really struck me about the project.
I think the students gain a new perspective on a lot of things. I think they gain a new perspective on what community life is. Obviously the kids, they don't have an opportunity to interact with people, again, from, you know, several time zones away. So I think it gave kids a new, broader perspective on the world, a new, broader perspective on education, and possibly even a new, broader perspective on themselves.
My favorite part of working on the Eigg project was seeing the different types of people.
My favorite thing was talking about who we want to be when we grow up.
I've learned that a lot of places away from us are very different. They dress differently, they eat differently, they shop different.
Again, so my age, from my generation, this is almost science fiction. If I was looking at this from the point of view from my kids when I was 12 years old, and if I said when I grow up I'm going to be not only teaching a class, you know, in New Jersey, but I'm going to be teaching a class at the same time on the other side of the Atlantic Ocean, again, it would have came across as nothing but science fiction. So this is, again, a wonderful educational experience for me as well. You know, I guess I never would have thought, even 10 years ago, that something like this would even be possible.
We learned so much from the Isle of Eigg through their conservation efforts and what we don't do here. And our students got very excited about being green and making our school green and talking about ways that we conserve energy. When they spoke with these students at the Isle of Eigg and heard that they only had so much power during the course of the day that they were allowed to use, that they were actually rationed power, And our students will walk around their homes with lights on and computers on and TV on, and they had an awareness. It was a consciousness, and you could see them sit back and think about, wow, you know, what is my impact here? And it opened up wonderful opportunities for the teachers to move forward with discussions about their impact on the world. And you know, that's global education right there. That was great stuff.
I've learned that, like, the resources that we have are very important, and not to use them all. If we use all the resources that we have, we will eventually not have anything left to survive with.
You see, and hide all by yourself. Call, then I'll call.